There is a new hotfix 1.0.7 and I'm going to talk about the important changes in the upcoming patch. This patch is going to be released next Tuesday, August 13th. I'm just going to focus on the changes that are important so that this video won't drag on forever. First is the changes on the Frostwalker. The difficulty of the Frostwalker mechanism will be adjusted so you can enjoy this Void Intercept battle through public matchmaking more easily. Now, I do believe Frostwalker is not a hard mode difficulty, but it's more like a mythic difficulty or higher than hard mode. There are a lot of mechanics on the boss fight that requires coordination that can't be achieved easily in a public matchmaking. For example, the Ember mechanic has a timer on the ground, and you and your party members need to time it properly with a DPS so that the Ember will not expire. This is one of the issues that needs a lot of coordination. Most of the time, the Ember will just expire because there are instances where the DPS is too low. There are also instances where the DPS is too fast, but most of the party members doesn't know how to get more flame or there is no runner. Another issue with this boss fight is that the information on the destructible parts is lacking. When you look at the image, there are weak points that are not included in the picture since it's 2D, and most of the time all the party members doesn't even know that there are three very important weak points that needs to be destroyed in order to gain more embers. There are three domes on top of the head of the boss that needs to be focused, but most of the players only focus the one at the middle. Each dome drops 4 embers and ignoring the other 2 is a big missed opportunity in obtaining more embers. Another issue with this boss is that the knee weak points are really hard to hit, especially when it is moving, and we only get a few seconds to DPS the knee weak points. This causes the immune phase to drag on for a very long time. Also, there is one attack that bypasses even if you have a proper cover, which is really annoying because you are already behind a cover. For me, what they can do about the Ember mechanic is simply extend its duration and it will greatly make the fight smoother. Also, the devs really need to change the images for the boss's weak points so that players will know what weak points needs priority. If we look at this image, there is a weak point that says brain, but it is kind of confusing as to what the target is because one might think that the brain is under the carapace, because why would a brain be outside? But when you scan, you can only see the domes behind the carapace, so this really needs to be emphasized more so that the players will know what to do. Another upcoming change is the monster HP reduction in Void Fusion Reactors and Ammo Drops. For all of you who doesn't know, Void Fusion Reactors are missions that you can find in any map where you need to defeat a commander, and it is also where you can open the amorphous material patterns which drops Crystallization Catalyst Blueprint, Energy Activators Blueprint, Descendant Materials, and Unique Weapon Materials. In order to activate the Void Fusion, you need Void Shards of a specific type. In my experience, most Void Fusion bosses or commanders are really tough and most of them are bullet sponges. There are also bosses that deal so much damage even if you are using a tank build, but it is not really a problem. The most prevalent problem is the bullets. After defeating one boss, most likely you are going to run out of ammo and you are going to go back to the outpost and use the support droid. The problem is that the support droid doesn't give enough ammo, and it also doesn't give ammo for high powered rounds for your sniper rifle, launcher, and shotgun. Now, I honestly don't know why this is a thing, but it is really annoying not having ammo for high powered weapons. Every time you go to any Void Intercept battle or boss fights, your sniper rifle only have 5 ammo in the magazine and 5 reserve. This is also the same with the shotgun and the launchers, which really sucks because it is simply not enough. Now, I know that high-powered weapons are really strong, but it is really crippling not having ammo for these types of weapons. I don't think this has anything to do with the game's balance, as this game is a PvE game, and there are descendants that can absolutely destroy any bosses in mere seconds, but for some reason, we can't have that for high-powered weapons. As of right now, it is really not fun using high-powered weapons unless you are playing Glay or any descendants that has abilities that can manipulate ammo. What I usually do is go to another map and come back to the map that I'm farming, which takes a couple of seconds in the loading screen since I'm using an SSD drive. But for those who doesn't have any SSDs, then they are going to be stuck in the loading screen for a while. Now, this can be solved by dropping more ammo or by simply buffing the supply droid to give as max ammo reserve on all weapon types. The ammo issue is also common in Void Intercept Battle. There are times when the ads doesn't give you any ammo even though you have 3 different types of weapons and you are just standing there doing nothing or waiting for the supply droid cooldown. Another change that I really want the devs hopefully will think about is to make the module socket type for the bullet improvement all the same. As of right now, electric enhancement is Santic, chill enhancement is Cerulean, toxic enhancement is Rutile, and fire enhancement is Almandine. I wish that they changed the socket type of these modules into the same module socket type. I don't really mind which module socket type as long as these 4 are the same so that weapon build can fit them easily. As of right now, some of my weapon builds are using half or level 4 enhancement level for every bullet enhancement because it just won't fit. This also goes for the descendant antibody modules such as electric antibody is Santic, cold antibody is Cerulean, toxic antibody is Rutile, and heat antibody is Almandine. These are the changes that are really important to me as this significantly improves the quality of life. These changes are a big step to improvement and I'm really happy that the devs are slowly changing things for the better. There are still so many issues in the game that needs improvement, but as of right now, these are the only issues that I can think of, and these are also the issues that were brought up by the devs. I really appreciate that the devs are slowly but surely fixing the issues with the game, and in the past couple of weeks, there have been a lot of positive changes that have really made the game more fun. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.